सो न्यूटन्स रिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट इज बिकॉज ऑफ डिविजन ऑफ एम्पलीट्यूड. सो हाउ द न्यूटन्स रिंग्स आर फॉर्म्ड, वी विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस दिस इन इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑल्सो. वॉट इज द अरेंजमेंट हियर? इनिशियली देर इज अ प्लेन ग्लास प्लेट, एंड ऑन द प्लेन ग्लास प्लेट देर इज अ प्लैनो कॉन्वेक्स लेंस, एंड देर इज अ एयर फिल्म इन बिटवीन द प्लैनो कॉन्वेक्स लेंस एंड द ग्लास प्लेट. There is a gap in between these two, plano-convex lens and glass plate. So this is an air film having thickness T. The incident beam is coming from refracted region of the light, that is the upper portion. AB is the incident beam. The light will incident normally from the region AB, or this is the AB light. And it is a concept of refraction. When any light falls normally to the second medium, there is zero refraction. Light will travel the same path. I am repeating it again. When light falls normally on another medium or in process of refraction, the angle of refraction will be zero and the light travel the same path of incident light. So here the same process is happening. The light AB is incident light and it will strike to the point C at the glass plate, and because there is a normal incidence, it will travel the same path, and one point is D here. So there is a gap in between the plano convex lens and the glass plate. So the light which is reflecting from the point B and the light which is reflecting from the point C, there is a superposition between these two light beams, which is designated as E and F here. So this superposition of the light will give the interference pattern in the form of Newton's ring. Okay, so again I am repeating the same thing. The interference occurs because of the division of amplitude, because there is a thin film in between the plano convex lens and the glass plate, and the light which is reflecting from the point B and the light which is reflecting from the point C, these two beams when interfere with each other, we will get the interference fringes on the screen. One is dark fringe and another one is the bright fringe, is obtained in the form of Newton's ring. And this was observed first by Newton, hence this is known as Newton's ring experiment. And the locus of this plano convex lens is spherical in shape, hence we are observing here the ring like structure. You can see in this figure number 3, the center is dark, this is a destructive interference, then bright, then dark, alternative dark and bright fringes are observed. So these are the constructive and destructive interference. And because of the locus of the plano convex lens, it is obtained in the form of rings. So this is a concept of interference when we have to find the condition of dark and bright fringes. We are getting the dark and bright fringes, so now we should know the condition of dark and bright fringes. Why we are getting dark at the center and bright afterwards, and again dark and again bright? So there is a reason behind that. So you should know the path difference between the two light beams which are going to interfere. The light which are interfering with each other, there is a path difference between this, and this path difference is denoted by delta here, that is 2 mu t cos r plus lambda by 2. Mu is the refractive index, t is the thickness of film, r is angle of refraction, lambda is the wavelength of light used. So this delta is known as path difference between the two interfering beams. Here lambda by 2 is added because we are observing from the reflected region of the light. This is known as effective path difference, and it is observed because of the Stokes treatment. There is a phase difference of pi between the light beams which is reflected from the reflected region or from the transmitted region. So the effective path difference is 2 mu t cos r plus lambda by 2. Now we will calculate the condition of bright fringe, it means the constructive interference, and the condition of dark fringe, that is the destructive interference. I have told you earlier that when light falls normally to any medium, the angle of refraction is always zero. So in the equation delta is equals to 2 mu t cos r, r will be equals to 0. So cos r will be 1. So 2 mu t plus lambda by 2 will be the path difference.